Self-awareness.
What does it mean? Means
really understanding the root from within, and I'm only speaking from my own perspective. Knowing there's a road that lies ahead, but you understand that there is a world around us. It's more than just the bubble we live in, that you live in, that I live in, that everybody lives in. And so, understanding you're not alone in any situation you're in or put in, and that with every situation, you know, there is always a way out, always a solution. You know, the root cause of what makes us react to certain things. And things that may come and try to plagiarize us may not always be the foe in every situation. Some things we would view, you know, the old saying, friend or foe, may not be the foes we perceive it to be. Maybe the friend is actually the foe, and the foe is actually the friend. It's just trying to bring out the real us. So we're not trapped in our own bubbles of self-absorption, but we, leaders of our own destinies, can't deny the fact something outside of ourselves, because the only way we truly understand ourselves is we understand the things that are over us and are much bigger than us as human beings. And that the foe that we think is coming to play us is actually the best benefit that we can know, possibly come to know, right? No. And that stepping out of the things that we just know we were born into, but the things that we're comfortable knowing, opening up the vessels that is within each and every one of us. So even though that things are in the unfamiliar, because really the foe, what is the foe? The foe is trying to bring at us. The foe is the unfamiliar. The unfamiliar is actually best friend. So basically self-awareness really comes down to what is the friend and what is the foe in it all. Because sometimes really the friend is not the friend, it is the foe. And sometimes the foe is not really the foe, it is the friend. You could see and view the foe as the unfamiliar, and the friend is just really the familiar. What is going to benefit us the most in the long run? is what one needs to ask themselves. Is the friend just comfortability, everything we're used to knowing, and just things that we want someone to come along and just tell us stuff we already know to keep us in a state of comfortability, and not just really in a physical all the time, but really more of a mental, spiritual state of being. But really, sometimes we just really need the foe to come along and release something out of us. Because even the unfamiliar can be the most beneficial thing to us all, because it's almost like every human being is a human race. We're all like plants. And so if we want to grow, we need the foe to come and water us, to take us out, and to not be in a garden that's dead. Water us with new seeds, to give us something brand new, something we've always needed, something maybe even your family didn't take, they had a chance to take, and they didn't know your friends, but it can really help you lay down your ego and pride, and keep your vessels open so a new seed can be planted, and you, and I. Self-awareness really comes down to what is the friend and what is the foe, and what is it going to take us to really, because the talk, people talk about evolution. Well, evolution can really lie in not just if it was a fish and it turned into a human being or frogs or whatever. It's really can come to a state of, it can really also be that it wasn't just, you know, the talk mammals turned into, evolved into human beings, but really I see it as more of human beings evolving in growth mentally, physically, and spiritually. But in order to do that, how do you view the friend and how do you view the foe? Because if someone's trying to grow you, and it can be even with baby steps, I view that as not the foe, even though it perceives from so many to be the foe, but as the friend that is putting you on the right track, to help, to giving you seeds and putting you in a fresh bed of a garden, as you can view it as I view it as, to help one's growth, evolving mentally, physically, spiritually in this life. Because as human beings, we need to grow. Why else would one say that we're here? One is here to grow and to know who they are within their growth. Self-awareness also, really, an important question to ask is, does it really come down to growth in all aspects? So we have beliefs in chakras, evolution, all these different beliefs, especially thrown around in today's time. And I could view it as, it's evolution of not really the belief as in mammals evolved into humans, but really it's more of a growth aspect. Physically, mentally, and spiritually, do I want to grow as a human being, evolve in all aspects as I can be, and be everything I can be? And how do I do that? With growth. And self-awareness, people would view it as, oh, it's just knowing about everything outside going on outside of our bubbles. Especially someone who's living in the United States, wherever you live, may live. But whatever your views or takes on it, I would say it really comes down to, are you open and receiving the foe as the friend? The friend is a foe, but really, how do you view the foe and how do you view the friend? Because humans tend to look at the outside too much rather than, what is this person's true intentions? They come off as however they come off as, but really, what if they really have something not so insidious, but really something to really help give us something greater than our own self? So that would be definitely something above our own understanding, and self-awareness can even go into something above even humanity's own small understanding of things. But it has to be something outside of ourselves. It has to be something above us. And really, the words I get, especially now, are trust the process, trust the process, and trusting the process, process, process. In all aspects of things. But really, who you are, what you want. Because you find whoever you view as the foe is that comes along in your life, but really is a friend in disguise. You're not unlocking just the thing you have found, but you're unlocking. You're unlocking the true potential that is in you, that is really laying aside ego and pride and really getting into a state of opening up to the friend. Is actually the foe is actually the friend, and the people I've been around that were I perceived as friends are actually the foes, because these people are not seeking growth, are not seeking evolution in a way, as in not the mammals into the humans as it's always stated, but really as in my take on it. I don't know how other people's takes are on this, but my views, evolution can come in the form of all aspects of who we are as Homo sapiens, as people, and opening up our vessels, spiritual vessels, whatever, and taking whatever this person has to offer, because whoever you're around the most is. And if the people that you're around are not open to growth, as in do not have the ability to lay down only the things they have known and don't understand the process of what it means to go find the things you don't know or don't understand. How do you expect for you to go out and understand and go after the things you don't know rather than just settling on the things you do know? I can say that actually came from not me, but actually words of Jordan B. Peterson, the man I watched a while back. And you already know the things you know, so why not go out and go get the things you don't already know? You already know what you know, so go out and get the things you already don't know. That would really boil it down to my example of what. So self-awareness really boils down to. Fire.